Ben season. Today I'm going to be reading you a book about the Lord. This book is called Jesus and His Disciples. This is the thumbnail or the book cover. So why not, let's go into the book. When Jesus was a young man, he traveled from village to village teaching God's message. Wherever he went, people came to listen to the stories he told. Soon, lots of people had heard about Jesus. Whenever he arrived in the village, a crowd quickly gathered to meet him. So this is the how the pictures look like. My ears might be a bit red because I'm a bit cold because it's in the evening here. Okay, next page. One day, a big crowd followed Jesus down to the lake. There wasn't enough room for everybody, so Jesus asked a man called Peter if he could use his boat. Peter pushed his boat a little way into the water. Now everyone could see and hear Jesus. So here is another picture.
Another page.
While Jesus was teaching the crowd, the other fishermen were putting their nets away. When Jesus had finished, he said to Peter, "Take the boat out into deep water and cast your net." We fished all night and caught nothing, said Peter. "But if you say so." There it is. Peter sailed to the deepest part of the lake and cast his net. Soon, the net was full of fish. It was so full that the net broke. Peter called the other boat over to help. As they hauled in the fish, the boats began to sink. Maybe the fishes are too heavy for the boat. The fishermen couldn't believe how many fish they had caught. Peter knelt down to thank Jesus, as he didn't think he deserved it. But Jesus said to them, "Follow me, then you'll be fishers of men." When they reached the shore, Peter and the other fishermen, Andrew, James and John, left their boats to follow Jesus. So then after the fishes start moving and flip-flop. You can see the words there. Flip.
Fish.
Jesus chose 12 disciples from his many followers. Peter, Andrew, Peter's brother, James, John, which is James' brother, Philip, Bartholomew, Thomas, Simon, Matthew, James the Younger, Thaddeus, and then Judas. One day, Jesus told a story. Once a farmer sowed some seeds. Some fell on the path where birds pecked them. Some fell on the stony ground and some fell in the weeds. But some seeds fell on good soil. What does this story mean? Asked the disciples. The seeds are the things that God tells us. Sometimes people don't want to listen to what God says, like the seeds on the path. Sometimes people forget what God tells them, like the seeds on the stony ground. Sometimes people are too busy to listen to God, like the seeds in the weed. But the people who listen to God grow stronger, like the seed that fell on good soil. All kinds of people came to listen to Jesus. Even bad people. "Why do you waste time on these bad people?" Jesus was asked. He told a story to help everyone understand. Once, a shepherd was looking after 100 sheep. He counted them up to 99. There was one missing. So he made sure his flock was safe and went to search for one lost sheep. There it is. The picture. The shepherd searched and searched until he found the lost sheep. Bah, bah. He was very happy and carried it over his shoulders all the way home. God is like the shepherd. He worries for the bad people and is overjoyed when they are found and are sorry for what they have done. So, guys, this is the end of the book. So, this is the finish of the book. So, we will have more bedtime stories because it's the evening right now in our country. And it's bedtime right now, so we were reading a bedtime storybook. Stay tuned, everyone, for more Bible stories, and follow and make sure to see you soon.